So here I am this morning in a strange place. Got off an aeroplane, my ears are not even working properly as we set this up this morning. And I'm just walking off to breakfast, kindly provided for me on food I'm probably not used to. Having had a super takeaway last night, you wouldn't believe. But everything's different. And the points of reference in life are different. I'm not driving somewhere, I'm walking somewhere. It's very easy to get to everything I want. I'm in the middle of a city. I can't speak the language, can't understand what anybody's saying to me or communicate properly. It's one of those times when things are kind of different, and just looking around, I may actually have lost my way. And you've got to backtrack. You've got to find your waymarks, your routes, points on the route to get to where you want to go to and where you want to be. And yes, get rid of that feeling of being suddenly adrift in a very unfamiliar place. Aha, yeah, sure enough, here it is. Here's the place I was looking for. It's a big shopping centre, and I've had to backtrack and get back to this. This is my landmark, and I shouldn't have gone that way, I should have gone this way. And of course, I was heading off, enjoying the sunshine, enjoying being in a new place, looking forward to breakfast, and oh dear, everything seemed great, but it wasn't. I was way off course. I need to go down there. It's very easy to go running after all sorts of enjoyment of the situation that isn't bread. And bread is the basis, isn't it? Bread is essential to us. That's what we need. I'm getting there now, I'm back on track. Yeah, this is good now. Yeah, there we are, we're on track. And down the bottom of the road there's the bakery. There we go, all is good. Well, walking out this morning, doing rather better at the navigation, I've happened to come across this little piece of graffiti on a wall on a building as I'm walking past it to get to where I'm going. What do you make of that? The sun will rise and we will try again. Strangely, that's in English, it's not the language of the place. And it also raises the question, doesn't it? Okay, sounds very, very positive message. Many positive messages are being peddled around out there to try and cheer people up. The sun will rise and we will try again. You can see the sun has risen here, it's pouring down my neck. Let's find some shade. Well, the question it raises for me is this: what are you going to try again? And when you try something again today, how do you know it's going to be any better than what you tried yesterday and got lost? There's an interesting passage in Jeremiah 6, and it goes like this. This is what the Lord says: stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient paths and where the good way is, and walk in it, and you'll find rest for your souls. But you said, we will not walk in it. Well, here we are. Here's the crossroads. It's a kind of a staggered crossroads, but that's just as well. Even though it's got traffic lights on it, somebody's trying to look out for safety here. But the people in our passage in Jeremiah 6, they are not looking out for safety. Look at what happens next. God says, I'm bringing disaster on this people, the fruit of their schemes. That's in verse 19. They'll have to live with the consequences of their actions that they didn't see being a problem, or wouldn't. It was the fruit of their schemes. And instead of keeping them safe at the crossroads, God let them run and have the consequences of what they'd been doing. So they were to have the fruit of their schemes, the consequences of their actions. And then secondly, this is verse 21, I'll put obstacles before the people. Parents and children alike will stumble over them. Obstacles, says God. First of all, they'll have the fruits of what they've done to try and make them wake up. Secondly, they'll stumble over obstacles that God leaves in the way. And then thirdly, verses 22 to 24, an army will come against them, cruel and without mercy. It says they will fear and they will tremble. This is the third thing. Firstly, the fruits of their actions. Secondly, there'll be stumbling blocks in their way and they just keep tripping up and it's frustrating and so on, not major injury, but then an army, cruel without mercy. And they will fear and tremble, but, verse 28, they're all hardened rebels going about to slander. They are bronze and iron. They all act corruptly, and they go on doing so in their trembling. Well, the conclusion of all of this, God says there, towards the end of the chapter, is this. The bellows blows fiercely to burn off the impurities, says God. But verse 29, the refining goes on in vain. The wicked are not purged out. You see what's happening there? They are being shown the way that they should go. They are, the things are being done to really bring them to their senses. The bellows, they make the fire burn fiercely, but they will not let go of the impurities that are trying to be corrected. And the consequence then is that they become rejected. They're called rejected silver, it says, because the Lord has rejected them. So look, there were those warnings. The fruit of their schemes, obstacles in their path, stumbling away. And then, you know, the fierceness of this army, fierce and awful. And they fear and they tremble, but they do not purify their hearts, turn back to God. And God says, here's the analysis. Yeah, the bellows are blowing fiercely to burn off the impurities, but the refining goes on in vain. And at the end of the day, they become rejected silver. The lead has not been burned, has not been refined out. The Lord has rejected them. So awful, so tragic, so unnecessary. Because in a world that they knew was coming apart, that they felt the pain of being in, they didn't heed the wisdom of verse 16, where the Lord says, stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient paths, ask where the good way is, and walk in it, and you will find rest for your souls. But they continue to say, we will not walk in it. So, there's my word for a week that I've spent in sunny Mostar in Bosnia-Herzegovina. I hope it helps in some way. It's a slightly extended one, because it's the mainstay of the Do-It-Yourself Sunday Service Kit this week. I hope it sort of helps in an age that is kind of falling apart. There's a sense of, oh, everything keeps tripping me up. There's a sense that, you know, things are not as they should be around us. And that's the time, says Jeremiah. That's the time to be looking for the old ways, for God's ways, to find the right ways and walk in them. Not to wake up in the morning and say, oh, every day's a new day. Not to wake up in the morning and say, it's another day and tomorrow we'll try again, you know? But to say, Lord, let's turn back to you. Let's walk in your ways. Let's walk in the right ways. Live in your truth and find the peace that he promises for our souls. I hope you have a great week.